ഇപ്പോൾ രാഹുൽ ഗാന്ധി രണ്ട് ദിവസത്തെ തെരഞ്ഞെടുപ്പ് പര്യടനത്തിനായി കേരളത്തിലെത്തി. രാഹുൽ ഗാന്ധി കൊച്ചി സെന്റർ എസ് എസ് കോളേജിൽ വിദ്യാർത്ഥികളുമായി സംവദിക്കുന്നു. തത്സമയ
സംരക്ഷണത്തിലേക്ക് You mentioned it right now that you're looking to empower women. I think that is fundamental, and I think it is one of the things that I would like to see change in India. So with that, let us start our conversation.
Hello. I now invite the questions.
Don't keep it just questions, you know. Be more relaxed. You seem very serious today. Are you stressed out? Are you worried? Or you relaxed? Yeah?
Yeah, all right.
Not only them, everybody. Are you stressed out? Louder. I can't hear.
No.
Okay, so I need you to relax because I want to have a conversation with you. I need you to be comfortable. If you're going to be stressed, if you're not going to be relaxed, it's not going to work. Okay, so anybody who feels like asking, go ahead.
Good afternoon, sir. Yeah. I'm Rosna Johnson from first year BA Economics Department. And my question is it possible to win a seat or successfully represent the people on principles alone?
What do you think?
I guess it varies with people. Different people will be having their own perspectives and life principles. So would you like to share yours?
Yeah. I think... Obviously, in an election, you're looking for a majority viewpoint, right? And in finding that majority viewpoint, that's a conversation, right? If I want to find out what is the majority viewpoint here, I have to start talking to people. I have to listen to what people say. And in finding that viewpoint, I can follow a principled position or I can follow an unprincipled position. I can do both. I can cheat you. Right, I can cheat you and I can come here and I can say three things that you want to hear. You might vote for me and then the next time when I got to come, then I'm in trouble. Right? So what principles give you is consistency and credibility. So you might sneak away with one election, you might cheat people once, but in the end people are intelligent. You got to give them that. And eventually they'll figure out what the person is trying to do. If you're In Hindi, they say niyat. If your intention is genuine, right, you will broadly follow genuine principles. If your intention is to cheat people, then you will broadly follow principles that cheat people. And then I think you can tell when someone genuine comes to me, I might make a mistake once. I'm unlikely to make a mistake twice or three times or four times. So I think that applies to politics as well. I don't find it interesting to do politics without principles. It's not interesting for me. So frankly, I wouldn't do it any other way. There might be a cost to it. I'm ready to bear that cost. I learn from these principles. I find these principles help me in my life. That would be the answer.
Thank you, sir, for the answer.
Tell me a bit about yourself.
I am Rosna Johnson and I am doing first year BA economics degree here.
So the boss of the college said that we are trying to empower women.
Yeah, true.
Do you think you're empowered?
Getting empowered.
And what does that process involve?
Like if I would like to tell, I could tell I'm in the stages because right now I'm running an online business. Which helped me to reach the final position.
Okay.
Yeah.
And so as a young lady, how do you know when you step into society that you're empowered? Like I would say to you, well, you face something that I never face, right?
Yeah.
I can get up in the morning, I can get up at night, I can walk on any street, I can go into risky places. I don't have a problem. As a girl, you can't do that.
Yeah, true.
Right? So there are many places at night you can't go alone. So are you empowered?
No.
So what are the minimum things you require as a woman for empowerment?
We also need a society who support it. As if you talked about walking alone in the streets at night, if we are ready to do, but we need a society who supports that and makes our mentally fit, like gives us a thought that it's always safe and all, but we are damn sure it lacks here, especially in our country, it lacks.
So for example, as a man, I will never face that.
Yeah.
I will never walk into a situation when I'm scared physically that someone might do something to me. It's just not something in my mindset, but all of you have that in common, right?
It's not even the case of night, even during the daytime we face the same.
Yeah, so can you be empowered if your society is not empowered?
No.
You sure?
Yeah.
What do others think? Do you think you can be empowered if your society is not empowered? No? Okay. Do you think Mahatma Gandhi was empowered?
Yes,
do you think
sir.
He was?
Yeah.
Was Indian society empowered when Mahatma Gandhi was alive?
Yes.
Was it? We were run by the British?
Not fully. Yeah.
But British ruled us. And we had obviously a society that was not empowered because the British ruled us, Maharajas ruled us. We didn't rule ourselves. And then you have this man who suddenly in a completely unempowered society has gone and empowered himself completely. Would you disagree with that?
But people were his strength, sir.
Okay. So, suppose you put Mahatma Gandhi in a jail and he didn't see anybody, talk to anybody, would he still be empowered?
But his people will fight for him.
No, but suppose nobody was allowed to contact him. He was 15 years in jail. So in those days, he's sitting in the jail alone.
Then he wouldn't be.
Wouldn't he be? What do you think? No?
No.
Does everybody agree that he wouldn't be empowered? Give her.
I feel like empowerment is individually, like...
Okay.
Just because he's in jail, physically he's in jail, it doesn't mean that he mentally is not empowered.
Okay.
That's why he became the father of nation, because he had the strength in himself, he believed in himself. So physically, even if he's in jail, I feel like he'll be mentally empowered.
Okay.
Because obviously he showed it after he came out, he did a lot of things. So that means obviously he was empowered during that time he spent didn't let that bring him down. He continued to fight.
But then, see, both of you are right. There must have been moments.
Yeah,
when Mahatma Gandhi inside couldn't deal with it anymore, and he said, now I can't deal with it, so then he was disempowered.
But you can't be sure because I haven't actually met him. It's just my opinion.
Yeah.
I believe that this is what happened, but...
So what do you need for empowerment then?
Confidence.
Okay. Anyone else?
People to believe in you, because... Those years he spent in jail, he must have lost his relevance in the country. But then it was because of the people who believed in his actions and what was his vision, that when he came back, he could be as strong as he was once before. So I think the society and the people who follow him played a huge role.
So people play a big role?
Yeah, they do.
What if you are... What do you do? What do you do well?
I write.
You write. What if you wrote really, really well? And you were absolutely convinced that you are an excellent writer. Mm-hmm. But everyone said you're useless.
I guess that depends on that person's mental capability, because I believe that I have a strength of my own, but if people kept bashing me down again and again, I'm not sure. I've never been in that position, but it's not something a lot of people can overcome. So it depends on the person, a person's strength, and through that vision, but then also how he empowers the people around him or her.
But if you were convinced, if you practiced writing every day, and you've been writing for 10, 15, 20 years, and you were convinced that what you were saying and what you were writing was good, and everybody else said, it's not.
If my passion in it is that strong, then right? I believe nothing can stop me.
Exactly. So, point I'm trying to make is empowerment. You can sit, you can relax. Point I'm trying to make is empowerment comes from inside. It doesn't come from outside. It is when you believe in yourself that you start to become empowered. When you falsely believe in yourself, you become arrogant. This is a different thing. Arrogance is not empowerment. Empowerment is correct belief. If she was a useless writer and she was convinced she was a good writer, right? And she didn't do any work to be a good writer, then she's not empowered, then she's arrogant. So that's, to me, the difference. I like that written over there. Yeah? The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.